We cut across to big charges made by Rahul Gandhi attacking the poll process. Rahul's big Modi poll attack, claiming these are not exit polls, what was displayed. It was all Modi media poll. Basically, that's the charge time and again against the large sections of the national media, which is called Modi media, Godi media, whatever they may. Here's Rahul Gandhi reiterating that all exact polls are basically of channels that are almost controlled by Prime Minister Modi himself, and the numbers that the exit poll surveys displayed were all influenced under Modi's pressure, claiming that India camp will indeed win 295 seats, rubbishing all the exit poll surveys, basically, the Congress face. Rahul Gandhi there claiming that they're going to get at least 295, the India bloc collectively. Let's have a listen.
इसका नाम एग्जिट पोल नहीं है, इसका नाम मोदी मीडिया पोल है. ये मोदी जी का पोल है, फैंटेसी पोल है उनका. इसका नाम एग्जिट पोल नहीं है, इसका नाम मोदी मीडिया पोल है. ये मोदी जी का पोल है, फैंटेसी पोल है उनका.
राहुल गांधी हु सेज दिस इज मोदी पोल नॉट एग्जिट पोल. वेल, इट्स वन थिंग टू नॉट वांट टू एक्सेप्ट what the exit poll results really say, another to completely dismiss the credibility of all the networks, agencies that have worked really hard to come up with these numbers. In fact, India Today's poll process has been, exit poll process has been that of great effort, where nearly thousands of constituencies that were surveyed, and we usually get it most often than not accurate. So, which is why we're credited. We are the most trusted exit poll. Time and again, we've proven our merit there. Congress party, of course, at this point, has refused to join any of the exit poll coverage, saying that they don't want to speculate. But now that exit poll results are showing a big sweep for the Modi government, it appears that Rahul Gandhi now calling it as Modi poll and not exit poll. Rahul Gautam, who's with us from the Congress office, but before I go to him, I'm going to take you through exactly what Rahul Gandhi has said yet again.
इसका नाम एग्जिट पोल नहीं है, इसका नाम मोदी मीडिया पोल है. ये मोदी जी का पोल है, फैंटेसी पोल है उनका.
All right, let me cut to Rahul Gautam joining us live from the Congress office in Delhi. Rahul, like I said, one thing to not want to agree with what the exit poll surveys say, another thing to say that all the media is fully controlled by the Modi government, that the exit poll surveys also are leaning towards him because they favor him unconditionally. Well, these are opinions one can have, but to dismiss credibility of all news channels, it really looks like a story of sour grapes.
Well, this is not a new charge that Rahul Gandhi has made. He has been saying that how, a large section of media is compromised and how they're being influenced by the by the current ruling dispensation. But if you talk about exit poll, results or trends, Rahul Gandhi has categorically rejected all these polls, saying that it's just a fantasy poll, it's a Modi a poll. In fact, when he was asked that what's the number for Congress Party of India Alliance, to which he replied, that have you heard the song name of Sidhu Moosewala, 295. Now, 295 is the number which all the players in opposition camp are repeating, again and again. We all know yesterday they all met at Congress President residence, and in fact they are saying that they have got feedback from ground zero from all the stakeholders, and they have concluded that that India Alliance is not going to win anything below 295. They are also saying that this is not for the first time when exit polls are predicting one side or landslide victory for BJP. They have been proved wrong in past as well. For example, in Madhya Pradesh, Chhattisgarh, although exit poll at that point of time also was pretty accurate at that point of time when everybody was giving the otherwise results. So clearly, it's a scientific process which certainly has been duly followed by Axis India Today poll. But that's the choice of Congress Party. They are rejecting it. They are not ready to accept it, saying that we are only going to believe the results that are going to come out on 4th of June. In fact, even before the exit poll results were out, Congress Party had decided that they are not going to participate in any kind of debate on exit polls, saying that they are already rigged and already in favor of BJP. However, it was only after the India Alliance meeting that they decided that they're going to participate, you know, in debate. So clearly, they are saying that this is not a gospel truth. They are not going to believe it and categorically rejected. And not even Rahul Gandhi. In fact, Akhilesh Yadav. There are many others who are rejecting all these exit polls, saying that one will be surprised on 4th June when India Alliance is going to get 295, and that's going to be the final tally for opposition camp.
For what exactly Rahul Gandhi said, to take you through yet again, here's a listen. While media asked Rahul Gandhi about the exit poll results, he said, "These are Modi polls, not exit polls." Listen in.
ये मोदी जी का पोल है, फैंटेसी पोल है उनका।
सर, कितनी सीटें आ रही हैं आपके हिसाब से?
सिद्धू मूसेवाला का सॉन्ग सुना आपने? 295। ये मोदी जी का पोल है, फैंटेसी पोल है उनका।
सर, कितनी सीटें आ रही हैं आपके हिसाब से?
सिद्धू मूसेवाला का सॉन्ग सुना आपने? 295।
Right, Rahul Gautam joining us for more on that. Rahul, I see there are some messages that are circulating on WhatsApp that are almost alerting people to be very careful. In fact, the India Bloc party workers itself very strictly warned that they've got to keep a close vigil on all the counting booths or the areas where the EVMs are placed, so that there's no rigging process that happens. It's not manipulated in any way, and to keep a close watch, ignore what the channels say, keep a close watch on all the polling, on the counting booths, so that there's no way that the ruling regime in cahoots with the Election Commission can rig it. These are claims made by the India Bloc members and the party cadres. These are messages being circulated as if a projection being made that India Bloc is winning, but somehow the ruling regime and the Election Commission is doing everything it can to turn it around in victory for the Modi government. Messages that are doing the round on WhatsApp.
Well, officially, Congress Party never, you know, doubted or raised any suspicion on the credibility of EVMs. However, there are many leaders, for example, Digvijay Singh and many others, Sam Pitroda, who had suggested that, you know, EVMs are rigged, elections are being manipulated by the current ruling suspension. However, the official stand of the Congress Party has always been that that Election Commission should count the VVPAT slips with the total number of votes, you know, polled, so that we can get a picture. However, there was a plea also that was filed before Supreme Court, which was rejected by the Supreme Court at that point of time. But you rightly pointed out that there are apprehensions that the Congress Party has been expressing about counting. In fact, today morning itself at around 11 a.m., Rahul Gandhi, Mallikarjun,
problem with your connection there. We're going to try and patch you, but we've got a sense of what Rahul Gandhi has in mind. The India Bloc itself collectively believing very strongly that the numbers that have come as part of the exit poll surveys are all false. It's fantasy numbers, and these are not exit polls. These are Modi polls. A clear word coming in from the Congress's Rahul Gandhi.